Hi everyone. There's a new movie that has come out called Snowpiercer. It was released here in the USA on July 18th, 2014. Now this has Chris Evans in it, the man that has played the Captain America and has been in the Avengers movies and such. Well, this movie has a lot of the symbolism of the end of the age in it, and a lot of the same symbolism that we show on our channel, of how these movies are as vision boards all around the world, that this same type of situation is shown in music videos and in many different movies. This movie could almost be the same as the Captain America movie, with them tearing everything down as they did in the Winter Soldier. And you can see here that this is all like in the winter. Let's take a look at this trailer here. It has been an apocalypse situation on the Earth, and they tried to do something with to stop the greenhouse effect. And instead it backfired and all the Earth has gone into a nuclear winter all across the Earth. And the only way to survive is be on this train that stays in perpetual motion all across the world. Otherwise, if you go outside, you would freeze to death. And in here, there, you will see that they talk about a class system. Like the people in the front are all in charge, and the people in the back are basically the slaves all through here. So let's take a look at this trailer, then we will show how this symbolism is mapping out the end of days.
This chaos. 1,000 people in an iron box. 18 years I've hated a train. 18 years I've waited for this moment. This is your world. The train saved humanity.
The engine lasts forever. The population
must always be kept in balance.
I said sit down.
Passengers, eternal order. Flow from the sacred engine. We must occupy our preordained position. I belong to the front. You belong to the tail. Know your place. Keep your place.
Those bastards in the front think they own us.
We'll be different when we get there.
What do you say?
We take the engine. And we control the world.
When is the time?
Soon.
This is disorder.
We're going to the front. Open the gate.
We know you well, Mr. Curtis. We've been watching you. Precisely 74% of you shall die.
I'm not a leader.
You're ready, our leader.
This is your destiny.
Well, it was a pretty good movie. It was very violent through there as the back of the train fought its way to the front. This had the same symbolism of the snake eating its tail, Ouroboros. See right here? The head of the snake gets everything and all things, living like a god or a king. The tail of the snake is the food. It's eating itself. This was the same thing on the train. The train in the back, they were even missing body parts and stuff, and they fought their way all the way up to the front and took over the head of the train. And then they were even offered, he was offered to take everything over, but he couldn't do it. He didn't want to be like the rest of these people. Otherwise, he could have had the head of the train and just, you know, kept on eating the tail. It was all set up for him. He ended up breaking the game, which I've showed is going to happen even in the Bible. The Chris Evans, who plays in Captain America, right here, he represented the Jesus figure going to the front. Jesus is basically going to take off his left arm See this left side? All of these different people over here, the trickery and stuff and everything. All the way down here to the child, which was the foundation of the new left arm. This little child ends up surviving out of all these other people get cut off. See right here? And he's the arch. See the arch go in front? This is leading everybody up and him taking down the head of the serpent right here. That's what this symbolism was all about right here. Just as in the Captain America movie, the Winter Soldier, he said he's going to tear everything down. Just as in here, he tore everything down. When he reached the front, this man who was in charge of the engine said he could be in control. But, like I said, that would mean that he would go back to eating his own tail. He didn't want to be like that, so he took everything down. Jesus Christ talks of this same thing, of taking off the left side. The left side is considered to be the accuser of all of us, and Jesus Christ sits at the right side. Oops. See, Jesus Christ sits at the right side. And when Jesus goes to the throne and takes the head, he's going to cut off this left arm. See, right here, he got rid of all these people in this movie that were doing trickery. He ended up losing even his best friend over here. But he got all the way down, and this little young boy was the last one to really survive. And he could grow the new arm, as they would call it, right there. But I just wanted to show that this symbolism is all through us. See how the bullhorns are all around? It's known as the fifth age in the Bible. It's the exact same thing in the Transformers movie. See the Transformers poster? He has the sword in his right arm. On this side, this woman is actually caught away, right here. And then this whole arm is basically torn off and has to be rebuilt as the woman is caught away to go to the throne when she's caught away in the Bible, like in a rapture. Same thing. See this side? The arch, the sword, and this side's being cut off. Confess with your mouth, the Lord is Jesus. Believe in your heart, God hath risen him from the dead, and you'll be saved. Hallelujah.